Let's take a look at a couple of examples and we'll calculate some of the typical voltages that you might run across in three-phase power distribution systems. We'll start off with North America. In North America, the voltage between a single phase and neutral is 120 volts RMS. What's the phase-to-phase voltage in a star-connected three-phase system? You might notice here, by the way, on this example, that I've changed colors. And the reason why I've changed colors here is because now we're talking about North America. In North America, normally hot is black wire, white is neutral, and then if you have a three-phase system, then the other two phases are typically either red or blue. What this problem tells us is that the voltage between any of the three phases in neutral is 120 volts. That's true for phase A, phase B, and phase C. The neutral lines are typically connected to earth, so we could call that 0 volts. If I label this the voltage of phase A, then that voltage is 120 volts RMS. I could also label this voltage VB and this voltage VC. All three of these voltages are the same in the sense that they have the same RMS voltage. They're all 120 volts, but they're not the same voltage because they're out of phase with one another. Let's write these three voltages in phasor notation. Whenever we write voltages in phasor format, by the way, it's important to remember whether or not the number that you're using as your magnitude here is the magnitude on the sine wave or the magnitude of the RMS. Here, I'm using the RMS standard. Our goal here is to find the phase-to-phase voltage. In other words, if I were to take a voltmeter and put one end of the voltmeter on phase A and one end of the voltmeter on phase B, what voltage would I read? It's not going to be 120 volts. 120 volts is the voltage I would read if I were to connect one side of my voltmeter to the phase and the other side to neutral. What we're interested in here is the difference. First, I convert polar to rectangular. Now we can add up the real parts and imaginary parts in order to get a single complex number. If we convert this back into polar form, we find that the magnitude is approximately 208 volts. It means that if I use a voltmeter, set it to the AC mode, put one side of the voltmeter on phase A and put the other side of the voltmeter on phase B, I'll measure 208 volts RMS on the voltmeter. From the phase information, we find that it's negative 150 degrees. What it means is that the voltage that I measure or the waveform is going to be out of phase with either phase A or phase B. Normally though, a voltmeter won't tell you the phase. It'll only tell you the RMS voltage. I'll get that same RMS voltage, 208 volts, regardless of which two phases I measure between. If I measure between phase A and phase B, it's also going to be 208 volts RMS. If I measure between phase B and C, again, 208 volts. In North America, 208 volts is a fairly common voltage that you might encounter, in addition to the single phase 120 volts. Let's now take a look at an example from Singapore, which is also common to most of continental Europe and the UK. In Singapore, single phase to neutral is 230 volts RMS. Let's find the phase-to-phase voltage in a star-connected three-phase system here. Let's go ahead and draw in our neutral point and label our phase voltages. When I work the problem this time, let's keep the other voltages in terms of the voltage on phase A. I can convert this number in polar form to rectangular form, and then I can subtract one from it. The magnitude of our voltage from phase to neutral was 230 volts RMS, or just VA. What's the magnitude of the voltage between phases B and A? Well, that's equivalent to taking the absolute value of VB minus VA. If I take the absolute value, it's just the absolute value of the product. So it's the absolute value of our voltage from phase to neutral multiplied times the absolute value of this complex number. We can find the absolute value of a complex number by using the Pythagorean theorem. We'll take the square root of the square of the real part plus the square of the imaginary part. There's the square of the real part, and there's the square of the imaginary part. This comes out to a square root of 3. If I want to find the phase-to-phase voltage, all I need to do is multiply that number times the square root of 3. So here in Singapore, the single phase-to-neutral voltage is 230 volts. If I want to know the phase-to-phase voltage, I just multiply it times the square root of 3. That gives me 400 volts. In Singapore, and in most of continental Europe, typical residences will receive single-phase voltages at about 230 volts. Three-phase installations also get 230 volts phase to neutral, which corresponds to about 400 volts face to face, which is just square root of 3 times 230. You might have noticed in my problems that I've used three particular colors to represent the three phases. I was using red for phase A, yellow for phase B, and blue for phase C. Well, that's not an accident. That's a color coding that you would find in many different countries around the world. This used to be the British standard, and more recently, the UK has changed their system or their color code to match what continental Europe is using. Singapore also recently changed their color code so that future electrical installations would match the color code of the UK and continental Europe. But many countries have their own color code systems. So if you look at, for example, residential or commercial wire colors in various countries around the world, you'll find all different colors. And you need to be very careful because you can't assume, for example, that the neutral color in one country corresponds to the neutral color or the ground color in another country. For example, in Singapore, using the old British color code, blue was one of the phase voltages. But in the new color code, blue is neutral. Well, there's a big difference between one of the hot wires and the neutral wires. The hot one is more dangerous. So you can't be sure, though, in a period of transition whether or not blue is going to be the phase voltage or whether or not blue is going to be the neutral. The old neutral color was black here in Singapore, but the new color code shows that black is one of the phase voltages. In North America, black is also one of the phase voltages. White tends to be the neutral. But sometimes in Japan, white can be one of the phase voltages. Furthermore, green is a color typically associated with ground. In North America, solid green refers to ground. But in China, green can refer to one of the phase voltages, so you cannot even be sure that green is going to be ground. One needs to be very careful if you move from one country to the other. You can't assume that the colors in one country match those in the other countries. What I'd like to do now is to go take a look at our power distribution box here in the lab and see what colors they're using in there. We have four current carrying cables coming in here to the lab and an earth ground. These lights here tell us that we have three phases available, red, yellow, and blue. And we also have the same three outgoing phases available. This orange conduit here contains many wires that then distribute power throughout the lab. Let's take a look at one of these circuit breaker boxes. You might notice that we have three circuit breakers here that are ganged together. This means that if one of these circuit breakers trips, then the circuit breaker corresponding to the other two phases is going to trip off at the same time. Now, these particular circuit breakers here are not color-coded, but we can see from the labels which phase each breaker corresponds to. For example, this says R, Y, and B corresponding to the red, yellow, and blue phases. Let's take a look at this other circuit breaker box over here. These are called single pole circuit breakers. They're not ganged together, so each circuit breaker only controls a single phase. And it is color coded right here. We can see, for example, that this top row of circuit breakers corresponds to the red phase. Row number 2 corresponds to the yellow phase. Row number 3 corresponds to the blue phase, and so on and so forth. This label right here also shows us in a pictorial way how the phases are distributed. So this picture of the box shows that we have three phases coming in here, and then the phases are tapped off in turn. First, the red phase is tapped off, then the yellow phase is tapped off, then the blue phase is tapped off, and then the process repeats. This ensures that power is distributed here in the lab in a sort of even-handed way among the three phases. We have a whole series of professionally filmed and edited videos in order to help students learn the fundamentals of electricity. If you like watching this particular video, then you might like to check out some of our others too.